I will request Mr. Dr. Someshwer Dutt from Sun Group to give his presentation.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Someshwer Dutt Sharma. I work for the Sun Group. Prior to Sun Group, I was working for the Wellspun. So it means that the in Wellspun, I have designed around 600-700 megawatt kind of solar PV power plant. And in Sun, we have the focus for distributed generation, which include the rooftop and small ground mount systems. So now this workshop is specially related to the rooftop solar assets management and operation and maintenance. So as per my experience, I can tell you that the rooftop system which I have found, it is more complicated than the ground mount system. For the designer point of view, it was very comfortable to design a ground mount system compared to the rooftop system. In rooftop system, there was the it's a kind of lot of issues and the challenges, especially when it comes to the stage of the proposal stage. Never you will get a AutoCAD drawing of the roofs, and business development team always behind you to give a good proposal without having a detailed informations. Even though if you will get some kind of good inputs, it will not be updated. You will get a AutoCAD drawing, but it will be no use for you. If you have designed the plant, you have optimized the capacity, so in reality, you will not able to accommodate that capacity over the particular roofs because of the so much, you will found the skylights, which was not mentioned, and vents, and the parapet walls, and the other kind of the shadow, objects. So just I want to highlight the few issues and the few knowledge which I have gained, and I want to just share with you. So in my opinion, that the ultimately rooftop systems or maybe the ground mount systems, only the matter how your plant is performing. So of course there was the lot of challenges which already noted down and speak about the my colleagues, but the major thing how your plant is performing, either it is the as per the your design or maybe there is some issues. If you will find in rooftop systems, even if they are very close buildings, these projects cannot be the identical. There are the lot of challenges. There could be the change in shape, there could be change in the roofs, there could be some barrier, maybe you will find lot of things which may impact the shadow over the plant. So that's very clear when you design the plant or the any team design the plant, shadow analysis should be on priority before to conclude the capacity of the plant. So it is not the your better energy generation, but it is the for the your client also, how much capacity really you can implement over the particular roof. Of course, it's you can customize for the end user, and then greater focus on the maintenance as well. So many time when you design the plant and it crossed the few months, you will found that the plant output lower than the your expected generation. I have seen few plants as well which was the energy generation more than the expected generation, but mostly energy was mostly time was lower than your design values. There could be the few factors of course related to the solar radiation and the other things, but which I have found in you can say that the challenges or maybe the issues majorly which I have observed the shadow inverter failure and your downtime from the grid side. So these are the three factors which I have found the main reason for the lower energy generation. For the module and the other thing, it is the, of course, the during the your selection and the other things. But in the plant, only the inverter is the, you know, equipment which is the running mechanically. So if team has not designed in proper way, assuming the shadow analysis and the other thing, so your plant is going to be hit by maybe many percentage of the, you know, kind of gap between your design and the expected energy generation. And downtime of the, of course, inverter hit a lot. Second, like you have heard, maybe the everyone is now belongs to the solar here, PV system analysis. So lot of just, it's kind of maybe the 30 minutes or 40 minutes kind of job for the designer to generate the PV system, which is the simulation based on your assumptions, maybe data from the meteor norm or solar GIS. Then you use the major files of the equipments like the inverter and the module, and then the losses as per your calculations and maybe as per your experience. So what majorly impacted, it's this soil which Andre also spoke about. So soil loss is not really, you know, kind of the standard input. Okay, 1% le lijiye, 2% le lijiye. It's not the kind of thing. It's a proper information, local informations. When your engineers do the site visit, so they should collect it about the kind of nature of that factory or maybe the place where you want to really, you know, implement your rooftop solar power plant. It may be the 3%, but if there is the lot of, you know, dust related business, maybe the cement factory or maybe the other kind of business where lot of, you know, trucks running over there, then the loss factor can go up to the 4% or 5% as well. So it has to be assumed very analytically way and the scientifically way. It cannot be just thumb rule. So that's the, again, the cleaning of the PV module. So in the contract, so lot of things has been spoken about the contract. In contract, you can, okay, O&M contract sign ho gaya ji, that the module cycle cleaning 2 times in a month. So total 24 times. And then if you found the module cleaning schedule, then you will get a, okay, 18 time was, you know, it was cleaned was the 18 times and rest was because of the rain and the other thing, it was not required at all. So that's not a proper way. So contract cannot, you know, supersede your actual conditions. There has to be some scientific way. That could be the, of course, the dust detection system. You will get a, you know, proper information from the impact of your loss of power generation, which should be related to the your dust detection system. Already such kind of the system available in the market. You implement such kind of the system over the roof and then do the operation and maintenance, especially related to the module cleaning. If you will not clean properly, that loss can go also the 6 to 7% or maybe more. And other hand, in the contract, always it is a kind of performance ratio. You are not cleaning your pyranometer properly. So if your radiation values are false, then how you will get a performance ratio value in line with the contract value? If you will see, you will ask your operation maintenance team, performance ratio bataiye iska, then it will cross easily vary the 90% more than that. How it possible? Your module temperature loss itself around 8% or 9% or maybe more in the, you know, hot region. Then how your complete power plant loss performance ratio can be more than the 90%? So it has to be very scientifically estimated with the proper kind of systems like dust detection system, or maybe you can use the two pyranometers where you can have the same kind of the glass like 4 mm, then see the solar transmittance values with the glass and the without glass, and then link with the your power output of your panel. So that kind of the way, if we can do it, so definitely you will improve or in line with the your designed energy generation. So these are the few important point where the your revenue impact heavily. So I have observed during my experience that this is the majorly because either the wrong shadow analysis or nobody has done the shadow analysis at all. Just they implemented the PV plant over the roof based on the roof. Second, it can be the failure majorly from the inverter point of view, or maybe the grid failure. Grid failure also goes like grid. If you have some failure, then the, it may be the 18 hours stop, 10 hour stop. Of course, it is the depend on the at what time it was the failure. So it has to be, you know, analytically we have to look at, and the reasons, proper reasons about the loss of energy generation. And when your plant has crossed the 1 year, so you forget about the that PV system which was used earlier. So if you have the correct data, you have measured the solar radiation accurately, and you have the belief on your team, then run the PV system based on actual radiation, which really senior management can review the operation maintenance team. That's the correct way to review the operation maintenance. If you are reviewing the operation maintenance based on the assumed data which was long back designed by engineering team and energy generation and the other things, so this is not the, in my opinion, correct way to use the actual data and try to measure the accurate data, especially solar radiation and the other things. And other practices which has been explained here, it is of course perfectly in line that you do the online remote monitoring, health check, and you keep the spares, whatever the required. But keep in mind that after 5 years again, this plant has to go for 25 years. So your relationship between your AMC provider should be fine. If some equipment like the inverter, if it was warranted for the 5 years, then it has to be extended before completing the 5 years. It has to be extended in proper way. Otherwise, then there will be the problem between the operational maintenance team and then the AMC provider.
Doctor, I will request you to conclude.
Yeah. So it is a clear cut, like the radiation and the other things. If you have utilized the WMO classified pyranometers, and the team has the good kind of the data logger, then you can measure a correct solar radiation, which is the key for the solar plants, either it is the rooftop or the ground mount. Of course, unavailability of grid, it is the main reason for the, especially in rooftop, when you will get a 10% kind of gap between your actual generation and the your design generation. And then you have a question during the board meeting, why it is lesser than the design values. So preventions, of course, you can take it. It's already has been spoke about. So that's all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, doctor, for your inputs.
Thank you.
I will request Mr. Rajesh Mehta from Ujaas Energy to have his presentation.
Good afternoon, everyone. Today's topic is what I have covered is opportunity for asset management after 15 plus gigawatt of installation. It will be a great opportunity for those who will do it with commitment in systematic and organized manner, give better and reliable service support, and create faith in customers. I want to share an example on this. I belong to Indore, and Ujaas headquartered at Indore. Some of you might know that Indore has received Cleanest City of India title in 2017. And this opportunity was converted into achievement by commitment, systematic approach, and connect with the stakeholder. Before advancing, let me familiarize you all with Ujaas Energy Limited. Ujaas has been in power sector since incorporation in 1979 as a part of backward integration from power transmission and distribution. We have started solar power generation. We are in ISO 9001 and 14001 certified company and listed in BSE and NSE in 2011. Ujaas has been felicitated by prestigious agencies like CARE, Economic Times, Business World, Forbes Asia. We are having presence in EPC and operation maintenance for ground mounted and rooftop with a workforce of 450 plus employees located across the country. We pay special attention on operation maintenance with biggest and most efficient team of Ujaas. We executed projects across the country and touched all the corners, right from northern part to Andaman and Nicobar, where we have done 1 megawatt of rooftop and 150 kilowatt at Port Blair Airport. At Ujaas, we are equipped with asset management facilities, various asset management, to carry out comprehensive operation and maintenance. We are having dedicated monitoring and analysis team, which regularly do effective analysis of all our ground-mounted and rooftop sites, including small plants on residential buildings from our central monitoring facilities. Here I want to mention that we are having a data logger on residential plants of 2, 3 and 5 kilowatt also. And that data we are monitoring from our central facility. We have our own transformer manufacturing unit, where we manufacture inverter transformer up to 5 MVA and up to 5 windings. Till date, we have supplied 100 plus of inverter transformers of various ratings and running successfully since last 6 years at different locations. We all know that transformer is a critical part of for any installation. It is an added advantage for any O&M company to have its own transformer workshop or facility. This is the chart which shows that average performance of all our plants from commissioning. And yes, you can say that every year we have been able to maintain consistent performance. Here are the some of the images for thermography. We are having dedicated team for all these things, thermography and module IV testing. This is the list of our esteemed customers, which includes Airport Authority of India and many banks, government sector organizations, public sector companies, bank, hotels, etc. Now we come to the opportunities. I am talking not about the rooftop, it is common for all. Design, installation and commissioning, was as previous speakers has also told. Design, installation and commissioning, quality and operation maintenance. These are the four pillars of any solar plant. And we have talked till now that about the first three pillars. Now it's time to pay more attention on fourth pillar, that is operation and maintenance. Current installation of 15 plus gigawatt and coming 4-5 years, it will be multiple. So it will be a very big opportunity for organized as well as unorganized player. Also, there will be a better opportunity generated for the support services like automation, skill development, security service provider. It will be a very big business for security service provider, consulting agencies, main power suppliers, local contractors for module cleaning and other works. Solar plant life spawn creates long-term business opportunity. I personally recommend long-term O&M contract, which is a win-win situation for both owner and the O&M service provider. Short-term contracts are just like renting a home, where vision is to complete tenure without thinking much on plant health, just to complete the tenure. And then after the tenure, it is again a challenge to hand over the assets and other liabilities to next O&M contractor. Where is a long-term O&M contract? This is like owning a home, where O&M contract works like a owner and takes every care of plant health, ensure permanent corrective action, and any installation left out work. As we know that there are many installation left out work which comes over O&M, they have to complete all those works. It Ujaas, 85% of our O&M contracts are for long term with tenure of 25 years. And I am happy to share with you that some of them have successfully completed 5 years of tenure. And we have achieved more than what we have committed in 100% cases, whether it is in terms of generation or CUF. On a lighter note, you must have heard a famous dialogue, "Ek baar jo commitment kar diya, to main apne aap ki bhi nahi sunta." It Ujaas, we follow the same. Once committed, then never show your back. It is a precondition to build for long-term O&M contracts. Now we come to the challenges. Every opportunity comes with some challenges. With innovation in technology, we are now looking towards 1500 volt of DC system. And that will be a big threat for existing system of 1000 volt, because we are talking for 25 years tenure. And if technology changes, then the things which are obsolete, that spare parts availability of those will be a very big challenge in next couple of years. And policy makers must think of this to ensure that all these spare parts will be available for 25 years. If suppose some inverter gets problem after 2-3 years, and then the inverter manufacturer will not give you support for the system which is already obsolete. Change in weather condition is also globally experienced, and it may deviate, as I said, it may deviate the generation from what was the estimated during the design. And major part of O&M cost includes salary and wages, what Mr. Puneet said, which is always in increasing mode. I have a data that central government has increased wages by 108% in last 1 year. I have compared the data from financial year 2016-17 and 17-18.
Mr. Rajesh, can you please come?
Greed unavailability and DISCOM non-cooperation, there are some other challenges also. Change in government policy, which is a very big challenge. Then water scarcity in coming years, which is now also has been experienced. I'll end my session with this slogan: Clean India, Green India. Think solar, think Ujaas. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. I will be the last presenter. So I will have it, and then we will have a session about the question answers. Good evening, good afternoon, everybody. most of the asset management related slides, which I also want to cover, has been covered by my panelists. We all are in the same boat, faces the same challenges, whether it's access related or whether it's a cleaning schedule related issues, or any inverter failure is the major factor. Plus, one of the point which was covered is the grid quality, grid failure. So my presentation here basically is slightly different than what my co-panelist has presented. Okay, O&M is the thing, but how if it is, it was covered that initially if the design phase is taken care properly during the design, the O&M activity is simplified. Yes, that's true. So if you follow the best practices, or call it as ecosystem, creating an ecosystem for the maintenance team, then it will be ease for the actual workers or the laborers and the engineers who are there on the site, who has to climb the ladder roofs. Mostly these ladders are monkey ladders, not easy to climb, height of 8 meters, 14 meters, so that's a height. So we, without frequently climbing up and down on those ladders, also is an issue. So if you have a proper system, make a preventive safety factors taken into consideration, then it's there will not be any hazards or accidents happening on the site. I would like to cover these aspects more in my presentation as in terms of O&M. First few slides about the organization. Cleanmax is the India's largest developer. We have almost 85 megawatt of the rooftop installations and 24% of the market share. Stands number one in terms of rooftop installations. We operate, maintain our system. It's on the mostly on the OPEX model. So investment is ours, and the unless and until we maintain it properly, the revenue will not come, and the lenders and the investor will not get the returns. That's already covered by Mr. Andrew also. So the PPA terms in the PPA has to be a proper. What are the deem generations? If the grid failure, how it is going to cover all those factors, and in no load is there on the Saturdays or Sundays or public holidays, how are you going to throttle your inverters? Or net metering is not always cap to consumption, is also these systems. If net metering is not there, then you have to throttle your generation because load availability of load is zero or very less. So on those condition, how it is going to be, that it all needs to be covered in the PPAs. Yes, we have team of engineers, mostly most from IITians and from the industries, covered from all directions: engineer, civil, mechanical, electricals. We were awarded as the best from the National Excellence Award from MNRE. Some of the clientels, what Cleanmax caters: food and beverage, IT, automotive, other manufacturing units and universities, government institutions, and many. The logos are self-explanatory. What are the best practices what Cleanmax is following in terms of the rooftop installations? What we feel as a visual display. When a person, when always going, as team is not the same. You train today one team, rooftop is the challenging thing. It's a turnaround time is very, very, very high in this industry. You train a person, after 6 months you find again the same safety training has to be given. You have to have the medical certification, entry permits. You have to go through the same cycle. That is the most hurdle. And if the same person is not there, then the new person, it takes time for him to adopt the new system because he has never worked on such an environment. So for adopting, and then it's bound to, because his work is to complete the train, model cleaning and the PM and just move ahead. He does not focus on the safety aspect. As you see in the last slide, the clientele base is very wide. So we have to follow mostly the safety norms. There are safety engineers, safety departments in all these industries. So unless and until you follow their safety norms, we are not permitted to work. So we feel that visual displays is a good reminder for the workers. So whether he is following the PPEs, whether he is following the safety norms, if not, he is forced to, his mental psychology also will force him to adopt those things. So that is one which will help engineers and the site team to implement the safety. The second challenge is the skylight we discussed. Skylights are the fragile sheet which are there for the natural lights in the industry. But that is the most hurdle in the O&M activity and the cleaning activity. Accident happens, it's not intentional. Person walks while cleaning or doing the maintenance, and the moment he steps on it, if the safety PPEs are not there, he is going to fall down and a major accident is going to happen. So all the skylight needs to be covered properly with the metal sheet, metal net, so that the light passes and the accident does not happen. Second is, while moving on the sloping roof, whether it's a RCC or the slope metal sheet, you need to have a safety lifeline installed so that person can hook his safety belts. Walkways, we are on the roof. Cleaning is, again, the frequency depends on the soiling losses, how much soiling it is, whether it's two times in a month or three times or four cycles. And when the person walks, frequent walking on the roofing sheet is going to damage the roofing sheet and the leakages may happen. So to avoid those, you have to install walkways all around wherever the walking movement is there. So that will protect the client's roof and also from the leakage of the rains or model cleaning water. As I mentioned, ladders climbing. We have carports and other super high structures either on the ground or on the roof. Then in such cases, we need to have safety ladders, a superstructure, carport, special lightweight movable ladders, because you have to move, you cannot have it one single location, with handrails and standing platform. Unless or until the platform is there, the person cannot stand and do his cleaning. He has to use the mop, he has to spray the water. So those, his comfort level is also an important factor. If he is comfortable, then he will do an effective cleaning activity. We, as I said, monkey ladders. Once only monkey ladders, if the landing platform is not there, then it becomes difficult for him to stand and hook his lifeline to the lifeline, his harnesses. So once he stands on the platform, then he can easily hook his belt on the lifeline. Again, ladders normal. We have seen people use bamboo ladders or n number of type of thing which are not safe for a person to climb on the roof. With handrails, it makes easy, his life becomes easy. The next point what I would like to have is the proper inverter and SCDV protections. Here the protection is not only in terms of putting the fire buckets or fire extinguishers, but it also in terms of shade, to prevent have a proper shade or a canopy on the inverter and the SCDVs. So when the person is on the roof working, the engineer, so he is also have his comfort level. Rubber mats are essential when it is a ACDB or when someone you're doing the maintenance activity, it will prevent him from the shocks. Platforms, if it is ground mounted installation, then in front of the ACDBs you have a platform, so the operations height, eye level interaction is there with the equipments and the meters. Traceability, that's a real challenge, because installations are done where you're not able to trace which inverter number one, what is the string, where it is connected, which part of my roof has that string. If ferrules are not there, whether it's a manual computer generated ferrules or other thing, so he has to trace it. Once the installation is done, tracing becomes very difficult. So proper identification in numbering system and the ferruling system has to be implemented, so the O&M work gets very is. So those are actually proper cable dressing. If dressing is done, then easy work is happens. Cable laid in proper conduit, it is aesthetically also good, and maintenance wise also it is ease. Arrows, cable direction of the flow of current, whether it's going towards the ACDB or going cable out, so it instead of opening all the conduits and all the cable trays, you know, if I have to trace the DC incoming cable, then I only open those particular cable trays instead of then finding. The reason why I'm mentioning this, Today, as the manpower keeps on changing, the plant has to be maintained 25 years. Today's engineer will not be available after 2 years. Definitely. So the person who is new on the site, he also need to, he will not be trained, or he will not be aware about what was done 4 years down the line, or 3 years down the line, or 10 years down the line. So all these things will help him for his activity to carry out effectively. Earth pits, basically type, it should cover, the nameplate should cover what is the type of earthing electrode used, what is the purpose or the location of the earthing pit, what are the earth values, what was during the first installation when it was done, when is the next earthing to be carried out, what is the next due date, what is the when was it carried out also. Fall arresters, we have already seen this part. Special tools, we basically use a special tools for model cleaning. So what are the, it's a brush with the water nozzle. Water is, scarcity of water is also an important factor in the industries. You don't get ample water, or also it's a ground mounted any system. So effective utilization of water is an important aspect. So brush with a nozzle where we can have less than 1 liter of per module water consumption. It can be lesser than that also, but currently we are able to achieve 1 liter. Expandable rod with is always, we see the matrix is not 2 by 2 modules or 3 modules, sometimes it is 4 modules in a single row or 5 modules. So you need to, the person should reach to the last module on the, when he's standing doing a model cleaning. So expandable things, rods is an important factor. When you're working on the modules, shock is electrical shock, any MC4 connector which is exposed may create an electric shock. So your rods should also have a protected from electric shock. So we use a carbon fiber cloth wounded brushes handles so that the safety is taken into consideration. Grass cutting, it's in the, basically not on the rooftop, but it's on the ground mounted. When it is ground mounted, vegetation control is one of the major factor. I will just skip this thing. Lot of panelists has covered about the indigenous or the monitoring system, what exactly it does and how other things. So I will like to skip those things. We have same way monitors, more than 100 of parameters. The data which comes to the server is either a 5 minute, 10 minutes or 15 minute cycle, depend on what type of your monitoring. We can monitor up to individual modules and the strings and the MPPT level. Auto alert, automated alerts and billing system is being implemented. That is standard operating practice for tracking of the site. This has also been covered, and drill down approach which has been specified. At the same thing what I mentioned, SLAs, tickets are raised. Then it is the tickets have been issued to the individual engineer, and we can track how many, after how many hours the work has been completed. And those datas are used for the future analysis, how we can avoid such situations. Some of the plant photographs, this is MIT Jaipur, Manipal University Jaipur, NBC Jaipur, GE Electric with the standing seam, carport at Nasik. This is Tata Nano plant in Sanand, Bangalore airports, Asai Chennai. That's from my end. Thank you, sir.
So, good afternoon, everyone. Definitely, it has been good perspective about how to manage the rooftop and distributed solar assets, and it has its own set of challenges, and also especially a lot of companies who are working on the RESCO, the OPEX model, needs to definitely gear up to manage their assets very well to keep on serving the investors. And since the morning, I think we had had a very, very good exchange of thoughts and presentation. So thank you very much,
I'd like to sincerely thank our distinguished panelists on the stage for enlightening us and sharing their wonderful experiences. I'm sure it will be useful for all of us attending the conference. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's make a big round of applause for. I'd like to move on and request our session chair and moderator, Dhananjay, to present small mementos to all the distinguished speakers on the dais, please.
Thank you.